Over the years, IBM has spun off so many businesses that you might wonder what they even do anymore. I mean, they literally invented the personal computer, but they sold their entire PC division to Lenovo back in 2004. They stopped making consumer printers in 91, computer chips in 2014, and Lotus Notes in 2018. So despite the fact you probably haven't bought an IBM product in years, how the heck are they still pulling in over $70 billion in annual revenue instead of going the way of the passenger pigeon? Well, like many companies, IBM still has its fingers in what made it successful in the first place, IT, but it has shifted its focus to areas it thinks will be more profitable in the modern age. And it makes sense when you think about it. Although PCs were Big Blue's bread and butter for a long time, they became commodity goods over the years with relatively low profit margins. But these days, IBM is focusing on services rather than selling physical products. One huge area where IBM is trying to become an industry leader is hybrid cloud. You're probably familiar with cloud computing in general. You use it every time you rely on Google servers to give you information about a local restaurant, or you ask your favorite virtual assistant what the weather's like outside. Hybrid cloud is a system that leverages public cloud systems that run public-facing services, like the examples I just gave you, in combination with an organization's own private cloud. A good example of a business that could use hybrid cloud is an online retailer, like LTTstore.com. Sensitive financial information could be kept on the retailer's premises with robust security measures to foil attackers. Meanwhile, much of the store's data and transaction processing could be handled by a public cloud system so that consumers aren't waiting, forever for a page to load or for a payment to go through. And the retailer could even buy more processing time and storage on the public cloud during heavy shopping periods, such as the holiday season, making it a flexible solution that's just more scalable. Because it's usually much cheaper for organizations to just buy the cloud computing muscle they need rather than hosting everything on site, IBM saw a huge opportunity to profit by offering their own infrastructure as a service. In fact, IaaS is a common initialism for products that offer cloud infrastructure as needed. Although IBM has a long way to catch up in this space compared to Amazon's AWS and Microsoft's Azure in terms of market share, the explosive growth in cloud computing, fueled by higher data speeds and consumer demand, makes it easy to understand why IBM is focusing on it rather than slinging PCs at Radio Shack like they used to.
Touch it for yourself at Radio Shack.
The other area IBM is really focusing on is artificial intelligence. You've probably seen those commercials for something called IBM Watson while watching TV. Wait, people watch TV? Watson is a natural language AI that, believe it or not, was first designed to answer questions on Jeopardy. But since then, it's expanded to support everyone from medical providers who want to ask it about the likelihood of a certain diagnosis, to large customer service departments who want to use Watson to replace their human workers in call centers. Unsurprisingly, this all means that IBM is courting business from large corporations like Citigroup and Verizon, who want to automate their operations as much as possible rather than relying on human analysts. And Big Blue is also hoping that Watson's focus on natural language processing will give it a leg up in a quickly crowding AI field. IBM has actually been working on AI for a long time. In fact, it demonstrated an AI that could play checkers all the way back in 1956. And since IBM has been focused on doing its own research for decades, they feel confident that AI and cloud are the ways forward. In fact, IBM is actually spinning off a large part of its more traditional IT business, which includes hosting network services and taking care of infrastructure for large organizations, as a separate company called Kyndryl later on in 2021. So it's clear that IBM has big ambitions. I just hope Watson doesn't replace the tech quickie staff one day. Or maybe I do? Big thanks to our sponsor, Private Internet Access. Check out Private Internet Access VPN, which masks your IP and encrypts your traffic with reliable service and no bandwidth caps. It has configurable encryption and an internet kill switch, which keeps you in control of your connection. Combine it with private browsing and make a website think that you're in a different country. Plus, connect up to 10 devices with clients for Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, and Linux. PIA also has recently launched its new dedicated IP option, which offers an even smoother internet experience while maintaining your privacy and security. With over 25,000 servers in 77 countries, what are you waiting for? Try PIA risk-free for 30 days at the link below. So thanks for watching, guys. If you liked this video, hit like, hit subscribe, and hit us up in the comments section with your suggestions for topics that we should cover in the future.